I wrote the book AI Value Creators along with Paul Zakopoulos and Kate Sewell because we see AI as the single largest value creation opportunity in our lifetimes. Technology is changing faster than ever. And if you're a business leader, it's not just about participating, but it's about how are you going to lead and become AI first in your business. Let's look at the big picture. Technology has gone from being roughly 5% to 15% of global GDP. So there's no question that there's a huge transition happening. Global knowledge work is 20 to 30 trillion. If AI boosts productivity by 10% or 20%, we're talking $5 trillion of value that's going to come from AI. And at its core, the AI value creator approach is allowing you to create and accrue value for your business leveraging AI. And I think the biggest challenge here is really about mindset. It's very easy to sit back and just use AI. But the real question is, are you going to generate value? It starts with this mindset of, we can't just add AI to our existing processes. We have to become AI first, which means it becomes a core part of our business strategy. One concept we feature in the book is the notion of the AI ladder. And we actually revisited this concept as a framework for AI adoption. Starts with data, how you collect, organize, protect your data. Then it's how do you add AI to your applications? Then how do you start to automate your workflows? Eventually, in many cases, you can replace your workflows. And ultimately, it's about AI doing the work. This is incredibly powerful. It's something we've done in IBM. And to date, we have saved over $3 billion and returned 4,000 hours of time to our employees by navigating this ladder using AI. The greatest asset for generative AI across any business, it's your proprietary data. And with millions of large language models in the world, here's the most interesting data point. Only 1% of enterprise data is contained within those models. That is your opportunity, which is how do you take your unique data, your proprietary assets, and begin to inform what your business can do with AI. That is the AI value creator mindset, and you can start to do this now. Now, to get value out of AI, I kind of think about three different equations to make it a bit simple. Number one is there's an old rule of thumb in macroeconomics about GDP growth and where does growth come from. It's been about population growth, productivity growth, and debt growth, the combination of those three. The issue that we face in today's world is there's not a lot of population growth, pretty much anywhere globally. There may or may not be debt growth. So growth for the world and all businesses is going to be about productivity. And there is no better lever for productivity growth than AI and how you apply it in your business to drive value. Next equation is about how you can use AI to drive outcomes for your business. It's about models, plus your data, plus governance, plus use cases. And the companies that I see leading in this area, they start with their data, but then they're quickly layering on how they will use multiple models, how they apply that to use cases, and do that in a governed and a responsible way. That is the simple equation for AI success. Our third equation is about how do you find the right balance between leveraging AI and running your core business. This is simply about the leadership, plus your skills, plus an open mindset on technology. The combination of those three will lead you to the right balance so that you don't swing the pendulum too far in one direction or the other, but you're very focused on value creation, leveraging AI that's designed for your business. Now, if you're looking for where to start, I would recommend you choose from the big three because we've worked all over the world researching this book, and there are three use cases that are dominant in terms of AI value creation. Number one is customer care. How do you serve your customers leveraging AI so you have better insights to have better customer experiences? Number two is about automation of your technology. Most companies start with code, but it could be extended to things like how you operate all of your technology across your business. And number three is digital labor. Perhaps the broadest concept of leveraging AI to complete repetitive tasks. So whether it's a task in supply chain, finance, HR, procurement, you name it, AI can be applied for digital labor to do those more accurately, more efficiently, and give your employees superpowers. We shared a concept in the book called an AI value creation curve. And the idea was, as you get experience, as you iterate, you can move up the value curve in terms of what you can accomplish with AI. Many people start with things like RAG, understanding their data, matures into technology automation and how you leverage code, moves to assistants, and then ultimately to agents. And I think this all sets the stage for the next driver of productivity gains for the enterprise, which will be catalyzed by AI agents. Agents will take the scalability that you achieve through new productivity and new ways of working, and the AI starts to work for you. So it's not about you deciding what has to get done. It's about you setting an outcome, and the agent will go achieve that outcome on your behalf. This is an incredibly exciting time to be working in AI, to think about what it can mean for your business and AI value creation for you. Download the AI Value Creators book using the link below.